Hello, everybody. This is Marty McConnell, and I'm back for another episode of How to Make Your Game from Scratch tutorial thing on YouTube. And I'm taking a look around my ship and thinking about what I want to kind of do. So I sort of touched on this on the last video. I think what I'm going to do is finish sketching out sort of a rough out shape for this so that when I apply my little modifier here, by the way, there's a little eyeball on these modifiers where you can see what they're doing, or you can turn them off for a minute so you can kind of see inside here. So you notice we've got this baffle plate here, but that'll come in handy later on. So that's the shape of my ship, and then if you click on the little eyeball again, then you're back to where you can see what that modifier is actually doing. We talked about switching between edit mode and object mode with both tab key and the menu. We talked about extruding objects, selecting stuff. So I'm not going to bother wasting a lot of your time with doing that. What I'm basically going to be doing is extruding, selecting, creating some new objects, and then either copying them over as a Boolean or maybe doing a Control J to join them to my little structure here. But for right now, I'm just going to go about finishing the ship. So I'm going to try and put this thing in high speed mode, and then you guys can kind of watch me fiddle with it without too many interruptions. And then when you're ready, then we will go ahead and come back and we'll start adding some guns and stuff. So, oh, the one thing I did want to talk about, I know I mentioned it in the last one, but there's a subdivide feature over here, right, when you're in edit mode. And actually, I need to have everything selected if I'm going to do that. There's a little subdivide feature here, and I already did it. Golly. Golly jeepers Jenkinson. Okay, now we're unsubdivided. So basically, whatever you have selected can get subdivided. We talked a little bit about faces and lines, but if you want to select things in mass quantity, like say I want to select all these things, then we can subdivide like this and like that. Another option is to use a subdivider modifier, which is over here, which will subdivide the entire model, because that acts, even though you can see it in edit mode, it really acts on it acts in object mode to get it done. Now, the only problem with subdividing by hand is you can see it does no smoothing whatsoever. So if we Control Z that and then just grab everything, if we add a subdivide modifier, then this takes into account some smoothing, so it smooths out your drawing as well. Now, the only downside to using a subdivide modifier is that you're going to increase your polygon count by a lot really, really fast by using it. But the good part is you don't need to worry about all that garbage, man, because basically after you do this and you get it set up the way you want it, we can always go through and clear these points. So I'm going to start out with a subdivide modifier, and you may see me use this other times on here. The main thing to watch for is just that your triangle count here is not getting out of hand. Now remember, this is going to be for a flat game, so we can get a little carried away if we want to, but I am going to try to keep the triangle count low. So once this thing starts getting really ridiculous, then we'll go back and fix some stuff. But in the meantime, I'm going to leave that to that, and I'm going to tinker with this guy a little bit more. Alrighty. And there's some settings on here too, which this is what it's actually going to look like, because that's the view too. And if we go to 3 subdivisions, we can get this super, super slick and smooth. And then I can go in and do some stuff with this that I normally wouldn't otherwise be able to do. Like I want to design a pretty cool looking cockpit. So I want that cockpit to be roughly near the front of the ship somewhere over here. So go ahead and render 2. So what I'm going to do, we started this with and I'll go to speed up mode in a second once I'm done with this. And you can see that bottom's kind of fanned out and getting a little retarded. So there are definitely some things happening here. And you're going to run into these little problems. This kind of crap's going to happen. It happens all the time. But you can use them to your advantage to make everything more colorful and cool, or you can sit and whine about it. But either way, I think this is looking pretty stellar, and that's a good thing for a stellar ship. It looks kind of like a duck face. Anyways, so I'm going to go ahead and apply my subdivision modifier. And now you can see we're still only in half mode here. And then since we started with the cockpit being about here, and this was going to be the living quarter, we can still have a fairly large cockpit. But one thing we can do is go to edit mode and go to our little points here. And we can kind of shape this to how we're going to want it to be shaped. So I can grab this little guy right here, and then this one, and we talked about the merge too, so we'll merge these at last. I'll go this one, and merge at last, and then I can go ahead and drag this over here a little bit, and drag this one down a little bit, and now we can actually make like an area that we can extend for our cockpit. And once we've got the basic location of it mapped out where we want it to be, then we can basically grab all of these by one of the means earlier noted, either just holding shift or doing control box. And then we'll do a scale modifier in the Z direction and kind of flatten this out. And then we'll do that again and make it really flat. And then we'll do that again and make it really flat. And now we've got a basic shape. And we can drop this into the smooth lining of the ship, like so, and now we've got somewhere that we can build a cockpit around, you know what I'm saying? And we can even bring this guy over to where we're kind of spacey looking. And we like spacey looking things because it's a spacey looking game. But anyways, I'm going to put this in fast forward mode. I'll dork around with this. Those are the commands that I'm using. It's pretty basic stuff. So stay tuned. If you see me scaling or whatever, just... if you get lost, just ask questions. That's what questions are for. Okay? Fast forward mode. Ready? Go. Alrighty, and we're back. You may have noticed this thing suddenly mutated as soon as that clip flipped over. Well, I lost the audio for the little follow-up clip. So I'll try and show you what I did. Basically what I did was I added some materials to these things. This glass piece up front, when I was making it, I applied a separate mirror modifier using our same little axis deal that I had from before, and I made this like a separate object when I designed it. So I added the modifier and it just completed that object. In case you were wondering, this is not attached to the rest of the ship. I used this smooth flat deal over here to do smooth shading on that and on the ship. I've erased these back engines because they were behaving funny. I think I accidentally applied a boolean somewhere along the line and something got screwed up as a result, and so I'm just gonna keep that. And I did a you can call it a decimate modifier, but what I basically did was I went to edit mode for this guy, and I don't even know if there's a button for it, but if you hit the X key, then you can do a limited dissolve on your ship, and you can set the max angle, and that's basically going to reduce the number of polygons that you have going into this, which is usually a good thing to do. So now I'm going to add my engine to this guy, and there are several good ways of adding an engine. I'm going to do a really cheesy way real quick, so you get a repeat of that, and I don't know how to undo this, so just Control-Z. And then I added some shaders. So to add the shaders, basically what I did, or to add the textures, what I did was I click on a piece in object mode and then go over to this little round button here with the little crosshair in the middle of it, and this will be blank. So I'll show you on when I do the engine mounts, but this will be blank, and you hit add new texture. You can rename it. You can click in here to set a color to whatever you want the color to be, or you can do light and dark with this little slider on the side. And then you can set your specular. This is basically how shiny it's going to be. So for the front window, I set it all the way to 1. And let's go ahead. We're in object mode, so let's add a mesh real quick. I'm just going to do a UV sphere. I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees here, like we did with the tanks, and I'm going to go to this mode. I'm going to go ahead and select wireframe and turn this back on dots, and I'm going to do a box select. So unselect everything and then do a box select for these and delete with the Y. And then delete with the X button. I'm going to do a delete vertices. And another thing I did before was this dissolve vertices button will basically get rid of a vertex, but it'll leave the lines and everything attached to it. So I did that at one point to remove a little stitching error that was attaching itself to this little scoop here. In case you were curious about that part of the video. And I am in orthographic view, so again, that's number 5 on the keypad. And then you can do 3, 9 to get this lined up where I want it to be lined up, which is right on the tailpipe here. And then I'm going to do a stretch Y. A stretch Z, SZ. And I'm basically going to shrink my little guy like that, and then I'll do a shrink X. Kind of curve him in like that and make a nice little flat deal. And then we'll go 7 and slide it into place over here. And then we'll just go ahead and scale this guy down a bit more and maybe fan it out a little bit more in the X direction. And then slide her over into place. And 7, shift down and kind of get this guy centered on here. And then we'll go back to regular mode so we can see what we're doing on the solids. Now, again, if you want to smooth this, you can go over here to your shading and do smooth. You can also do vertex shading in edit mode, which will actually move these little points around to smooth them. So in edit mode, you can shade the points themselves to kind of smooth everything out with, smooth vertex. And in object mode, you can actually set the shading to either smooth or flat to get a different effect. And that's actually pretty close to what I want. So I'm going to go ahead and apply my modifier here, which is going to be a mirror modifier to this. And I'm going to mirror across that center axis that we put on there in the first video. And I'm going to go ahead and color these guys. So I'll go to my materials tab and hit add new. And I'm going to call this engine black. And actually, there should already be one in here because I already made it. But basically, you create a new one, you name it, and then you can go here and set it to whatever color you want. So if you want it green, then you can have green. I normally just leave that in the middle, drop this down to black, and drop my specular intensity down to zero so that there's no shinies on it. And that'll give me my engine specs that I want. And if it's possible, it's going to be a trick. Since I already did my little modifier over here, it's going to be hard to get in there to the engines and adjust those. But whatevs. You know what I'm saying? I don't really care. And I'm just going to leave those as a separate piece instead of making them part of the ship. That way they can have different textures. Now if you want to do some coloring here, what we can do is we can grab our ship itself and go to faces, and we should be able to select some faces that we want to color, and we can do a new material, and we'll call this yellow paint. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and assign this to a yellow color. And we will brighten it up. Some fire yellow. Now you notice it's painting the entire ship, right? So it's not really what we want. We want to assign these two guys to that. So for our material, we actually want this. And then there should be a way where we can assign just the selection . Okay, so I might have to look up some YouTube videos on how to do this, but I should be able to do those two. I'm just going to call this gunmetal, and that'll be their ship color. And then yellow paint, assign. And select all. And do gunmetal, assign. So I'm not sure why these are being this way, but if we go to texture paint mode, wow. Okay, and then we're not going to be able to do it there. So we're going to have to figure out something else for the textures, which we can go to later on in another video, because I'm going to have to do some looking up. But basically, this painting thing, there should be a way to just assign these guys to a group. I think it's actually right here. We can do a plus yellow paint, and then we can assign. And then we've got yellow stripes on our ship. So that's how we do it. You gotta go up to this one up here, and then yellow paint and assign. We can go ahead and add another texture here and call it red paint. And we can go down to red and go ahead and drop the intensity down on it a little bit. And now our yellow was, let's change the intensity on this to 0.5, make it a little brighter. And now for our red paint, we can do essentially the same thing. We go in here and figure out where we want our red paint. So let's just say we want to select that one, and that one, and that one, and we can just kind of click around here to figure out where we want our red stripes. And then the front of this is going to be a little weird, but ultimately we can go in here and do a little bit of coolsies on it just to kind of give it a sort of a flare effect, you know what I mean? So go ahead and paint a little smiley face on here. That looks good, and then we'll go ahead and hit red, assign, and couple ammo. Now we've got a nifty little paint job on our ship. So, frightening, isn't it? Tab. If we wanted to, we can actually go in here, and I'm having way too much fun with this now, but don't want that. Yeah, that looks pretty bad. I like that. And we can go to yellow paint assign. And then we've got some cool looking war paint on our ship. Just something to make it look good. And that's how you can assign textures to Blender. Please tell me I have the audio on this thing on this time. Anyways, so you can basically paint your ship piece by piece, and if you want to, just make sure when you name your textures, you name them what you want them to be, because these are going to become important later on. And actually, instead of naming these yellow paint, red paint, it would have made more sense to name them like fuse color 1, fuse color 2. That way, in game, the player, you can even set up a thing where these particular texture areas can be modified by the player in game if you want to. So that's how you can set up like skins for your ship, you know, if you're into that sort of thing. And of course, from overhead view, looks pretty dang awesome. We got some little yellow lightning spear kind of things. And when you're designing the layout of the ship also, if you're really wanting to get crazy and carried away with paint, you want to keep this in mind while you're drawing all these little lines and while you're extruding as to like where the lines of your ship are, so that you can do stripe paint jobs on them and stuff like that later on. Or you can just kind of wing it like I did and end up with something, you know, that's not completely boring, but not exactly super intended anyways. And then if you want to get a look at what your ship's going to look like in real life, you can zoom out and you can play with the settings for this guy. I've changed this to, because when it starts out it's on point, I basically changed it to sun, and then I rotated the little beam around a little bit. And actually I can go overhead and rotate it a little more this way. It would probably look a little better than my ship. Now I'm using the R key. You can also use the little rotate button right here and move these axes and set this to global or local or whatever. Find the R key tends to work best. So this is your selection and stuff. And then zoom in on your ship. And since the sunlight's shining from this way, we'll go ahead and zoom in from this way and go to where you'd normally select wireframe, go to rendered, and then you can get an idea what your ship's going to look like in 3D when it's actually rendered out. There'll be some little black lines in here, don't worry about that. That'll get taken care of by the game engine. And then you got yourself a ship. Know what I mean, Jellybean? Alright, so that's it for this tutorial. Now we've got our basic ship and we've got some lines on it. So next we'll be importing this guy into Godot and we'll be doing some stuff with it. So stay tuned for that. Subscribe to the videos, and I look forward to seeing you in the next one where we actually get this guy in the game and hopefully get him to do something. Now that we got a little kind of a weird looking ship, but you know, we're ready to rock and roll. So stay tuned, stay integrated, keep gaming, keep programming, and I'll see you soon. Bye.